Yeah, so Tony, as I was telling you off the air, I don't know how we're going to get Hrbek out of bed at like, you know, 8:45 in the morning. I don't know how that's ever going to happen. I'm not a big believer that he's going to get up that early. I mean, he usually gets up, I think, around noon. I think Laudner told me that Kent usually gets up around noon.
Easy.
What's happening, pal?
What's going on?
This shows you how sad my life is, Kent, that I got very excited when I heard you were going to be on a show every week.
Yeah, that's my life. I'm going to be talking to you way too much.
Way too much. So things are good?
Yeah. How do you talk about last year? I guess just, you know, we went through something we've never been through before and you know, still practicing putting on the mask and trying to be safe and all that kind of stuff. And luckily enough, stayed away from getting anything myself, but so far. Mm-hmm. And just kind of going through the motions here. It's nice to see baseball coming back, so we get to, you know, and then, you know, watching stuff on TV, sports on TV again. I know the world's not all about sports, but I think it picks up the morale of people a little bit and gives you something to do. And now we're going to be able to go to the ballpark and watch some baseball games. Watching TV this morning, seeing some stuff about the high school hockey tournament that's back. So things are returning to normal, which is pretty cool.
I got to tell you, Ken, Sports Fridays with Ken Hrbek every Friday morning at 8:10 on KQ, sponsored by Killebrew Old Fashioned Root Beer and Cream Soda. When I heard we were going to do this, Kent, I was very, very excited. Like I said, you, the timing of the Twins and the KQ morning show was just, man, it was meant to be. And this was meant to be too. You've always been a terrific friend. And I got to see, we got to get you and Laudner and Norberg and I go out and play golf. We got to do it.
All right, play golf, go have a bite to eat, do something, yeah.
First time in life, this is the first time I've ever said this, probably the last I'm ever going to say this. You ready?
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Hrbek.
Boy, that was sincere.
That was really sincere, Tom. Kent, I am very excited about Fridays, every Friday morning at 8:10 on KQ. Looking forward to the entire season spent with my pal, Kent Hrbek. Thank you, sir.
Tommy, thank you, and thanks Jimmy Lundin and Killebrew Root Beer for helping out with this deal. Jimmy's a great guy. He always takes care of us down in fantasy camp, which we didn't have this year, which we missed because of COVID. But Jimmy goes down to fantasy camp and supplies us all our beverages down there, not only Killebrew Root Beer, but there's also some other beverages he supplies for us, and we have a great time down there in fantasy camp and looking forward to seeing him at the ballpark. And what a better sponsor to have on the show here than Killebrew Root Beer, huh?
Couldn't agree more, Pally. So we will talk to you. So you'll be on this Friday morning, just 3 days from now at 8:10, correct?
Yeah. Check your schedule, Tommy.
I thought for sure you were going to say, well, not this Friday.
We're going to be on Thursday, I think the 15th of April. I'm going to be on a Thursday morning instead of Friday because I'm going to be on an airplane on Friday morning, but we're going to move it to the 15th, I guess, on a Thursday morning. But other than that, a Friday morning regular.
Absolutely. We'll get it done. Thank you, Mr. Hrbek. I appreciate your time today.
You guys have a good one, and we'll go Twins, huh?
Go Twins. Absolutely.
Thanks, buddy. See ya.
Thank you. Bye. Again, I'm one of the luckiest men on earth in so many different damn ways, but looking at becoming friends with, and he used to torture me when that team of the ownership was pissed off at me, half the players were pissed off at me, people getting in my face, and the more they got pissed off, the more Kent would go, hey, Tommy, how are you?
Yeah, that's what friends are for. Rub your face in it. Bust your chops.